Wipe your whiskers. Secret Eaters is back. With a quarter of the UK now clinically obese, we hold the crown as the heavyweight champions of Europe.
15 stone 2. 17 and a half stone.
5 and a half stone heavier than I want to be.
Just how many of us are in denial about what we really eat?
I'm going wrong somewhere and I just don't know where.
I eat healthy things. I don't understand why I've got an 8 stone. It's literally like carrying a human being on my back.
Our PIs and covert cameras have been catching the nation scoffing everywhere. And I mean everywhere.
I've got a tracker on Tracy's car. Even if we lose her in traffic, we can find out where she is.
And when you see what we've uncovered...
They're on the move.
The truth will really knock you out. Oh, yes. In the Secret Eaters incident room, we'll be plating up the truth and nothing but.
Surprise!
Hello, ladies.
Hello.
Because if you really want to lose weight, you need to know how you're putting it on.
I just want to die now.
Oh, please don't put it in your mouth. Please don't put it in your mouth.
It's going in.
Are we hiding the true extent of our mindless eating from our loved ones and ourselves?
Can't believe you did that.
This is Secret Eaters.
I've got to take you on the chin, haven't I?
Really? Which one now?
No, very nice.
It's estimated that around 42% of office workers gain up to a stone in a year. The workplace, it seems, is the perfect breeding ground for secret eaters. And two office mates desperate to change that statistic are 22-year-old Faye Compton.
I'll bring up the availability and have a look for you.
And 30-year-old Laura Denning from Surrey.
There's a couple of people in our office and they're always ordering chips and cheese and garlic bread and all the stuff that I actually try to avoid, yet they're tiny.
Once nearly 20 stone, Laura has achieved weight loss before, shifting around 4 stone in total. But in the last 6 months, that weight loss has curiously ground to a halt.
I go to the gym and I give it 110%. I come out and I'm absolutely sweating, yet I'm still overweight. What else can I do? I just don't know.
While Laura's friend and work colleague, Faye, has mysteriously piled on a mammoth 8 stone in the last few years.
It's literally like carrying a human being on my back. I eat healthy things. I just don't know where I'm going wrong.
These two working girls have gone into overtime trying to understand why their excess weight isn't clocking off. So I've come for an urgent board meeting.
Hello, are you lonely?
And top of the agenda is their worrying bottom line figure.
Just take me through more or less what you're eating during the day. Do you have breakfast?
No, never have breakfast. I'd rather have the extra sleep in the morning, so I get up, get ready, enough time to go to work and get to work. I might grab bananas, satsumas, some sort of fruit. Generally in the lunch I go to my nan's, I have jacket potato, which I think is healthy, and I don't have any butter on my jacket potato. I have a tiny bit of cheese and a tiny bit of coleslaw, so generally that's quite good. And dinner, I try to have a third at least of my plate with veg. Again, I think it's a healthy, balanced diet.
Do you drink at all?
Alcoholic drinks?
Mm.
Not really. I'm not a big drinker.
So it's a bit of a mystery, to be honest.
Yeah, definitely a mystery.
Right, OK. So, Laura, take me through the sorts of things you might have.
I don't eat bad. I'll grab a banana or a yoghurt for breakfast, and maybe lunch I'll have, a soup or a sandwich.
I do think I pick really healthy things. I eat salads and soup at lunchtime, so I do think that my diet is pretty good.
So we've got a bit of a double mystery going on here.
But before we can help solve anything, these baffled work buddies have got an appointment with the Secret Eater scales.
How much do you think you weigh?
Oh, I think about 18 stone.
About 18 stone. Hop on. OK, you are 19 stone. So a little bit of a shock.
Yeah, just a bit. Because I don't want it to get any bigger than that. It's got to stop now.
Hop on. You're 15 stone 10. Bit surprised.
That's probably a stone more than what I thought.
So we really do need to get to the bottom of what is going on with you, lady.
Because
there's only so many rhinestones you can wear on your shoulders as distraction.
I know.
These office mates might work 9 to 5, but they've agreed to let us monitor them 24/7. We've placed cameras in the lounge and the kitchen to get a front row seat and watch what they really eat.
Do not now be thinking, I'm just going to eat a lettuce leaf and that's it because, you know, I'm terrified about being overweight. I need to see what you're really eating.
OK.
Is it a deal?
It's a deal.
Deal.
All right, fantastic.
To get an idea of what they think they eat, we asked Faye and Laura to complete a food diary over the course of a normal week. Laura claims a healthy average of just under the recommended 2,000 calories per day for women, with salad and home-cooked meals on most days. In Faye's diary, she listed eating just over 1,400 calories a day, with healthy lunches and plenty of vegetables. With the cameras rolling inside the house, I need to make sure we keep a track of what they're eating outside too. So I've called in my very own Starsky and Hutch, otherwise known as Cameron Gallett and Duncan Mee. These guys are two of the best private investigators in the business, and they'll be using every surveillance trick in the book.
All I need is to take photos, get me the evidence.
To capture any false accounting.
They're on the move.
Their mission? To track them wherever they go. And our surveillance won't shy away from Faye and Laura's day job either. Because for the first time ever, we're rigging an entire office with hidden cameras. And if Faye and Laura do decide on a quick skive in the staff room, we've got it covered, right next to the tempting treats of the vending machine. Faye doesn't normally live with Laura, but she's moving in for 5 days so we can evaluate every morsel they eat. But will our souped-up surveillance reveal that Faye and Laura are, in fact, secret eaters? Our workmate's first night under observation is off, and wisely, so's the cat.
Get ready to rumble!
And it's not long before Laura puts her new house guest to work, cooking dinner.
Can you not just do it?
What?
This?
Hey!
On the menu is easy-peasy tortellini, but they're making a right meal out of cooking it.
Well, you've got to do that, put it in a pan.
Put it in a pan with water, cook for 5 minutes, strain it. Then this, you just pour over the top, little stir, shush, warm it up, bang.
But this express meal shouldn't be careering either of them off the calorie chart. And gold stars for Laura for the green on the plate. For two ladies who do plenty of exercise... Oops, a little blast on the pasta there. This simple supper certainly doesn't explain their mysterious weight gain. So we'll keep our eyes peeled, but they aren't the only ones we've been watching. Food markets, the mecca for some mindless munching up and down the country. With so much grub up for grabs, we've placed our surveillance cameras in London's Notting Hill to see what the great British public eats on a day out at the market. So what light snacks can we fit in the space between breakfast and our Sunday roast? With such a huge choice of gourmet on the go, we want to know which one the public will go for. Which food will win the street battle? Will it be the calorific Chinese? At around 500 calories, will it be oodles of noodles? Or will we be saying well done in more ways than one to the 550-calorie burger? Or how about the healthier, humble jacket potatoes at just 400 calories? Or will the 500-calorie belly-busting burritos wrap this up and take home the crown as most popular? Our secret cameras will capture everything. Find out later which little piggies came to market. Coming up...
Surprise!
Shut up!
Faye and Laura face some home truths. Faye, can we have a word about this?
Oh, my God!
And our insider doesn't hold back about Faye's favourite meal.
It's a standing order.
Right. Express.
And she convinces me this is healthy.
Nearly a quarter of British women are obese, the highest proportion throughout Europe. And this is certainly true of workmates Faye Compton and Laura Denning from Surrey, who want to find out why the weight is piling on as neither of them think they overeat.
I think we've tried everything, haven't we?
They agreed to round-the-clock surveillance for 5 days to monitor every mouthful and had two PIs hot on their designer heels.
Laura's gone into the gym. I know there's a cafe in there, so I'm just going to go inside and monitor it.
Do they eat more than they realise? Laura and Faye now think their time of being watched is over. As far as they're concerned, they're on their way to London to stay at this trendy apartment in a converted warehouse, ready to meet our dietitian Lynn. But this is not strictly the case. We've rigged the entire place with hidden cameras, and hostess Jess is part of our stunt. And that's not all. Sealed behind this fake wall is our incident room, containing every scrap of evidence of what we saw them scoffing. But will they spot the subtle clues we've placed all around the apartment?
There you go.
Thank you very much.
Hi, Faye. Nice to meet you, Laura.
Oh, my God.
I'm
sweating. Isn't it lovely?
Office girls Laura and Faye are blissfully unaware they're about to be given a full appraisal of their eating habits.
She can't help herself. Faye's eating already. We're right on the other side of the doors. Shall we reveal ourselves?
Surprise!
Oh, my God. Shut up. Go away.
Hello, ladies.
Oh, no.
Now, Faye, no. Can we discuss the biscuit that's in your hand already?
Oh, my God. Oh, no.
Ladies, welcome to your very own instant room. Up you get.
Oh,
come
God.
On in. This is a mere snapshot of what we caught you two eating. Faye, can we have a word about this?
Oh, my God,
Laura, recognise it?
Yeah.
Fancy any of it?
No.
Come over here, girls. This is our surveillance board.
My God.
Look at that, squirting the mayonnaise at the top.
Oh, my God.
Please tell me that was Halloween.
Yes. Oh, my God.
Recognise the office?
Oh, no. Oh, my God.
We have got all of the food logs, and we have been monitoring and counting every single mouthful. We've had our spies as well watching you. Do you want to see more of what
God.
We caught on camera?
Oh, my God.
Step this way, please. You are guilty as sin.
The first generous helping of surveillance is dished out to Laura, a gym bunny whose weight loss has stalled.
With my weight loss, I feel like I've just hit this sort of plateau and, like, it's not going anywhere anymore, and I just don't know why.
No idea why the weight's plateaued?
No idea.
We think we might have found something.
Oh, God.
It's Monday morning, and Cameron follows Laura on her way into work, where she stops off at a local coffee shop. Like millions of other Brits, it seems Laura enjoys a coffee hit first thing in the morning.
I just caught what Laura ordered, and it was a large hazelnut skinny latte and a cinnamon swirl.
It's just a normal day at Laura's office, except our PIs had an early start and sneakily rigged up a bunch of cameras poised to capture any devious desktop dining.
Oh, this is your
God.
No.
Once at her desk, Laura wastes no time getting stuck in, swigging on her supersized sugary latte.
What are you doing?
As scheduled, the cinnamon swirl joins the breakfast meeting, showing that Laura knows a thing or two about time management.
I can't watch!
Breakfast out of the way, and Laura's off to hang out at the coffee vending machine. I bet this isn't listed on a CV as other interests.
It's that!
The following day, and another morning visit to the coffee shop with crack PI Duncan on her like foam on a cappuccino.
Right, on our way into work, Laura bought a large, skinny latte hazelnut syrup.
What am I doing? How many coffees have I had?
It seems at work, Laura's got quite the sweet tooth. But what about out of office hours? It's late night, and Laura's craving another sugary hit.
Oh, no.
How many calories?
Don't know. Oh, God.
So little.
So little.
Alone in the house, and our sweet tooth predator is ready to pounce on her next sugar-packed prey.
Oh, no.
That's when I wasn't there.
Really? Secret eater.
You might have kept that cupcake a secret from Faye, but you can't hide that tasty treat from our surveillance. The next day, Laura's hit the gym hard, but when she returns home, she seems to have a mysterious guest in a plastic bag with her.
Oh,
hey,
oh
what's that?
It's a chocolate twist.
A chocolate twist.
In my gym outfit. Oh, my God, I'm mortified.
But just a few hours later, she's at it again.
Another Twix. Oh, God.
No. You want to invest in shares, Twix?
What are they?
I just want to curl up and die.
And the bad news is about to get even worse for this sugar babe. Expert dietitian Lynn Garten has over 20 years' experience in nutrition and knows just how sickly sweet all this secret eating is.
I think you'd better turn round. You need to.
Oh, my God.
OK. Lynn, can you explain why you have built an ice cream mountain, please?
Well, Laura, if you continue to eat the same number of calories as you do from your sweet foods and your drinks, in a month, that's the same number of calories as these 113 strawberry sundaes.
No!
You averaged out around 700 calories a day just from your sweet foods. But not only that, you had around 400 calories a day from your sweet drinks, your coffees your juice. Now, if you just cut those out, did nothing else, you could end up losing a pound a week.
I'm absolutely mortified right now.
Laura's a standard sweet snacker. If, like her, you like your sugar hits, try swapping those artificially sweet snacks for a natural alternative. Fruit, small amounts of dried fruit, nuts, seeds, and even malt loaf are excellent alternatives to stop that sugar craving. With the full extent of Laura's snacking laid bare, it's Faye's turn to piece together the puzzle of her mysterious 8-stone weight gain.
Faye, would you say that your main meal is a sort of reasonably diet-conscious, health-conscious meal?
Generally, in the lunch, I go to my nan's and have jacket potato, which I think is healthy, and I don't have any butter on my jacket potato. And dinner, I try to have, you know, a third at least of my plate with veg.
Should we see what our surveillance says?
Yeah.
Oh, God.
It's Sunday, and that means a roast. And the girls have opted for chicken a la butter. Although Laura's doing the cooking, it's Faye who's in control of the size of her portion.
How many potatoes would you have? About six. So you'd have that. Yeah.
Six whole roasted. Not exactly a light dinner.
You've got the smallest plate in the world.
Oh, no.
That's just a starter.
Faye.
Like them. I know.
Oh, God.
We all have big portions. Feel full. Well done, but I'm going to eat them. I've got a strip.
Let me just take this jumper off.
It's hard work.
You've got the proper meat sweats. So... Look, and she's back for more.
Here we go.
It was a battle, but Faye's pushed through and cleared the lot.
Oh, no.
According to Faye, her normal lunchtime routine is a much lighter affair. Every day, round at Gran's, her so-called light bite is a daily jacket potato. Sounds healthy enough? But Faye's is nuked in the microwave with lashings of beans, cheese and fried mushrooms. RPI's managed to get there first to get the gospel according to Gran.
So she has this every day?
Every day with coleslaw.
And there's no variation? She doesn't have a different meal on a different day? Every day it's the same thing?
It's a standing order.
Right.
A standing order! Like you're a regular.
That's how she likes it.
And she convinces me this is healthy.
What we'd really like to do is put a secret camera in here.
Oh, no.
Is that okay with you?
Yes, I want to help her.
With our insider on board, Cameron and Duncan place a hidden camera just above Faye's usual perch.
My belly's on the table.
Oh, no. Your nan must go through some cold sore each week.
You've got to even it out.
And more. That's half a tub of cold sore you've just put on there.
Did you have any idea, Faye, that your nan was an undercover agent for us?
No. Oh, she's such a grass.
Brilliant. It's great that she said she tries to convince me this is healthy.
I do.
Well, let's find out just how bad that daily lunch that your nan gives you really is, OK?
OK.
Lynn.
Faye, the jacket potato is actually a healthy meal, but then you added 850 calories worth of extras to bring that meal to 1,150 calories.
What? I've never said that, cos I don't have any butter on it. I used to have butter on it, and now I don't have any butter on it.
You're actually outraged.
I am.
Without the butter, I used to have butter on it. Angry.
I can't believe it. That's a lot. That is a lot, though. And something I genuinely thought was healthy.
Lynn's undressing Faye's jacket potato to see just how those calories pile up.
Faye's jacket potato, on its own, was fine at around 300 calories. Then she added half a tin of baked beans at around 170 calories. Next, Faye added around a third of a plateful of fried mushrooms, 130 calories. Next, she added 3 heaped tablespoons of coleslaw, 300 calories. Then she added grated cheese, 250 calories.
But that was just Faye's healthy jacket potato. What about the other dinner we saw?
Well, your roast dinner came to 1,500 calories. So, Faye, your portion sizes are large, and that could be because you skip breakfast, and when you do come to eat, you're over-hungry and you overeat, eating huge portions.
Faye is a classic plate clearer, persevering until the entire plate is empty, despite her body telling her she's full. If you're like Faye and find it hard to leave food on the plate, be aware of your portion size from the word go and opt for smaller servings that would fit into the palm of your hand, and listen to your body's signals and stop when you feel full. Did you know that 1 in 3 of us don't get enough sleep? And all those restless nights can leave us very tired and a little bit grumpy. Or maybe that's just me. But can they also affect what we eat the following day? I'm meeting up with Dr. David Lewis, one of the UK's foremost food psychologists, who thinks he might have the answer.
What we're going to be looking at tonight is whether, if you don't get enough sleep, it's actually going to affect the amount of food you eat. In fact, research has shown that people who get too little sleep can weigh 30% more than people who get 8 or 9 hours a night.
So how are we testing this tonight then, David?
Well, Anna, I've booked you into a comfortable hotel.
Very kind of you.
But, of course, there is going to be a catch. What I'd like you to do, Anna, is to wake up at 1 o'clock and go and wake up half our guinea pigs.
OK.
And give them an IQ test.
This sounds like fun, yeah?
Because we want them to get out of bed, which will wake them up even more, and then use their brains.
And have to answer them.
Yeah, exactly. Okay. So, the following day, they'll be much more likely to go for the high-fat, high-sugar foods if they've had a disturbed night rest.
Well, this sounds like great fun. I'm going to leave you here because I need to pack my rollers.
Okay.
That's all right.
Off you go.
See you later.
Bye-bye.
We've invited 8 volunteers to spend the night in this hotel under the surveillance of our cameras. They've been told tomorrow they're taking part in a study about how lack of sleep affects mental performance. But the only thing we're interested in is what they'll eat. Split into 2 groups, one will be left undisturbed and the other woken up twice through the night. Lucky them. Time to get some shut-eye. It's 1 a.m. and while the lucky group are left to sleep soundly, it's time for me and psychologist Tom Dixon to give the unlucky half a rude awakening.
Tom, I love you, but I'm an older woman. I'm exhausted. What do you need?
It's time for the 1 o'clock wake-up. Come on, let's go.
What are we doing exactly?
We're going to keep them awake for half an hour with an IQ test.
Brilliant. I'm going to look forward to this. Come on, then. Let's knock and run.
To avoid our disturbed sleepers finding out they're on Secret Eaters, I need to stay incognito.
Scientific pyjamas. Watch this.
So, Group 1 are wide awake-ish and filling in their tests. Once all 30 questions have been answered, they can crawl back to bed.
So, what happens now?
And at 4 o'clock, repeat the procedure.
Did you say 4 o'clock in the morning?
4 o'clock in the morning.
You're on your own. Night. I'm off to bed.
Good night.
4 a.m. soon comes around, and sleepy Group 1 are disturbed yet again with another IQ test.
30 minutes.
We'll be coming back later to find out which group eats the most the following day. Coming up, we find out which foods hit the spot for our weekend market snackers. And Faye and Laura discover the shocking truth behind their secret binging.
You got through around 2,670 calories just in alcohol. It's the same as eating 744 sausage rolls.
Office workmates Faye and Laura from Surrey have asked us to run the numbers on their inexplicable growth curves.
I just don't know where I'm going wrong.
They've already had a large helping of evidence.
That's when I wasn't there.
Really? Secret eater.
Laura, who told us she eats a healthy diet full of salad and protein and does plenty of exercise, has her habits put under the microscope again.
I do think that my diet is pretty good.
Laura, how often are you eating salads and homemade sandwiches?
I would say every day.
OK. Healthy food?
Yep.
Or is it?
Oh, no.
Monday morning's packed lunch is a promising start to the week.
Oh, here we go. See? Yeah. I knew I had salad.
Ooh, it's certainly a healthy lunch. But what's this? It's a guest appearance from the salad cream.
Come on, son.
Fortunately, there's still some left for the following day's fully loaded stuffing and chicken sandwich.
Squeeze it in.
OK, Lynn.
Well, your sandwiches were coming in at over 500 calories each.
Oh, my God.
But then you were adding the salad cream, added another 50 calories, you have the crisps, another 130 calories. So your savoury meals are coming in at around 700 calories just at that one time.
And you thought they were healthy and low calorie?
700.
God.
Surely you must feel a little bit defeated inside.
Oh, God, definitely. I think now, seeing everything, I think I've been lying to myself because I think I've been trying to convince everybody else that I'm still really fit, I'm still really active, you know, telling my trainer that I eat really well. I think I've actually started telling myself it.
So, denial?
Yeah.
So when your trainer sees this,
he's going to be absolutely mortified.
He's going to have kittens.
But then it makes sense. I mean, he must know as well that actually you wouldn't be this size if you weren't eating too much.
Yeah.
He must know.
Yeah, he knows.
But now you know.
But now I know.
All the evidence is starting to sink in with our girls. But Faye and Laura aren't the only ones under snacking surveillance. We've got our beady eye on the British public too. We're in London's Notting Hill, at a bustling food market where our hidden cameras have been spying on shoppers in need of a feed to see just how we act around food. It's been suggested that catching a little glimpse of high sugar foods or a whiff of high fat releases the feel-good chemical dopamine, making you crave food even more.
So with a choice of every food under the sun, which store had the most draw at the end of the day? It definitely wasn't the 400-calorie jacket potato, who comes in fourth place with only 20 sold. In third place with only 35 meals sold, it's Chinese, and certainly wasn't the special of the day. 95 gut-busting burritos ended up in people's bellies, putting it in second place. But the outright winner for 180 diners was the big, fat, juicy burger packed with 550 calories. So there we have it. The most popular food at market today was also the most calorific. This lot have got a lot of shopping to do if they're to burn that off. Back in the instant room, it's time to cast our eyes on the final evidence of Faye's mystery weight gain.
Faye, is there anything in particular, do you think, that you could cut down on or maybe cut out?
Not really.
Hmm. When we met, you said, I'm really not a big drinker at all. Do you drink at all?
Alcoholic drinks?
Mm.
Not really. I'm not a big drinker.
It's Halloween, and PI Cameron has had a tip-off about a family party.
Faye's inside, and the party's about to kick off. Unfortunately, I'm sitting in a car outside.
But Cameron won't be on his own for long. He has an informant inside getting all the evidence he needs to give Faye a fright.
Oh, no!
So while Faye's clearly giving up the ghost of staying sober, our informant, her ghoul friend Jo, nips outside to share her findings with Cameron.
Oh, hell!
Faye's had about 4 or 5 PIMs, and we're now playing game with shots. Drinks are absolutely non-stop.
Oh!
The next morning, Cameron heads round to Faye's dad's to find out just how much alcohol Faye consumed last night.
Oh, my God!
Oh, what a grass!
How much do you think she did drink last night?
I'd say she probably had a good 20 shots.
What about this Jaeger bomb that's sitting here?
I missed that one. She missed it out.
4 or 5 again of those.
A staggering 3/4 of us trying to lose weight admit to overindulging at the weekend. And for Faye, the booze binge doesn't stop there.
Oh, exercise. No.
On Sunday and Monday, Faye consumed yet more alcohol.
Oh, God.
20 shots in one night.
And that was just for starters. What about all the other drinks and everything that you had?
Well, we need to find out from Lynn whether all of this partying is actually having an effect on your waistline. Lynn?
It certainly is. On that Saturday night, you got through around 2,670 calories just in alcohol.
Oh.
Over surveillance, you average out at around 1,240 calories a day just from alcohol. Now, if you did this every day over a course of a month, it's the same as eating...
Oh, my God.
Not just one.
What?
744 mini sausage rolls.
Oh, my God.
And the thing is, with alcohol, you drink it in addition to your food. You don't make any substitutions for your food. You don't restrict anything else. So it's all added calories on top of what you eat on a day-to-day basis.
No, that's shocking, that.
Was it?
Yes. Because I don't think, I only think about food, not the drink.
Now that Faye and Laura have seen all the evidence, it's time for them to learn the difference between what they think they eat and what they really eat.
Faye, according to your food diaries, you thought you were getting through 1,400 calories a day. During surveillance, you actually got through 4,100 calories a day.
Oh, Laura.
Faye.
Oh, that's like, oh.
Twice as much as you need.
Oh, I don't even know what to say.
Yeah. Okay, what about Laura?
Laura, according to your food diaries, you thought you were getting through around just under 2,000 calories a day. But during surveillance, we caught you getting through 3,000 calories a day.
So you're overeating by half again.
God.
Shocking.
Yeah.
Well, there's one more confession to get out of you. Faye, are you a secret eater?
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh. Laura, are you a secret eater?
I am. Oh, God.
I seriously didn't realise how different my diet is to how I say it is. What I say and what I do are two completely different things. I've basically tricked myself into thinking when I'm maybe putting that Twix in my mouth that I've just eaten a salad, when really I haven't. I've eaten a Twix.
I won't forget today in a hurry, but it's because it's been good. It's been a good day for me. I want to use it to help me. So when I think, you know, even if I do fancy something a bit naughty, I can just think of that and then put the donut down.
After seeing the true extent of their secret eating, Faye and Laura have agreed to stick to a healthy eating plan. In order to start shifting some pounds, Faye is going to have to stick to a calorie intake of 2,000 a day. She must cut down on her calorific cocktails and eat more regularly in the morning to avoid those monster-sized meals at lunch and dinner. Laura will have a new meal plan of around 1,800 calories a day. She must say no to the sugary sweet snacks and focus on eating three balanced meals throughout the day. Those simple changes will hopefully turn things around and start the weight loss. We'll be catching up with them later to find out how they got on. If you'd like to change your eating habits and for more help and tips, then visit us at channel4.com/secreteaters. Earlier on, we invited eight people to unknowingly help us test the scientific theory that if we don't get enough sleep, we'll eat more and make unhealthy food choices.
An IQ test here for you to do.
Last night, one group had their sleep disturbed twice to do some IQ tests, while the other group was left to sleep undisturbed. The next morning, both groups think they're being tested on mental performance, but really, we're working up their appetite to see who eats more. Dr. David has prepared identical snack bags for each of the groups. Science says that the yellow bag, tired group, will not only eat more, but also choose more sugar and fat-laden snacks. While the blue bag, awake group, who slept undisturbed, will make more healthy food choices and will snack less.
And there's definitely some snacking going on.
Activity's over, and Tom and Dr. David get busy calculating the results based on the snacks left over by each group. It's time for our sleepy and unsuspecting guinea pigs to find out the truth.
Hello, guys. Hello. Good afternoon. You obviously thought that you were brought here to take part in an experiment to do with team building. It's not quite the case. We had a whole different reason for bringing you here, because you have been taking part in a show called Secret Eaters. I'm going to hand you over to Dr. David Lewis, our psychologist, to explain what we've been doing.
Hi. Yellow team, we woke you up. It was a very cruel thing to do, I know. What we wanted to find out was whether the following day, because you'd been deprived of sleep, you would eat more than the blue team over there who had a good night's sleep.
With the secret out, time to reveal which group ate the most snacks.
Yellow team, how much more did they eat than the blue team, David?
35% more. You tended to eat a lot more high-fat, high-sugar things. You were particularly keen on the white chocolate buttons.
So we've proved the science beautifully, that if you do have a disturbed night's sleep, you are more likely to eat more food the following day, and in this case, you ate 35% more than the group that slept well.
I had no idea. I just thought, regardless of how you sleep, you eat normally.
Knowing what I know now, definitely I'm going to sleep full 8 hours. I'm not trying to get fat.
So there you go. Once again, the science has been proved. It is so important to get a good night's sleep, particularly if you're trying to keep your weight down. Sleep well, snack less. Well, this one is definitely off for a kip.
Coming up.
Ready?
Yeah.
Do it.
It's weigh-in time for Faye and Laura. 12 weeks ago, friends and workmates Faye and Laura were struggling to unravel the mystery of their widening waistbands.
I don't understand it, and I have never have. Like, I can't warrant now as well why I've put on 8 stone. It's literally like carrying a human being on my back.
With my weight loss, I feel like I've just hit this sort of plateau, and like it's not going anywhere anymore. And I just don't know why.
So we put them under round-the-clock surveillance, had two top private investigators following them everywhere.
I just caught what Laura ordered, and it was a large hazelnut skinny latte and a cinnamon swirl.
And then revealed the true extent of their secret eating in our incident room.
This is a mere snapshot of what we caught you two eating. Faye, can we have a word about this?
Oh, my God, Faye!
It's now time to see if they've changed their weighty ways.
The first thing I did when I got home was I went shopping, ready to get going that following morning. I have replaced all the sweet treats and the sugary foods with actual proper food.
I now manage my portion sizes by trying to fill, you know, at least 50% of the plate if I can with salad or vegetables. I'm still having the jacket potatoes, but I've been having, you know, slightly smaller in size, but just beans and less than half the cheese I was having before. And now I don't even have the coleslaw anymore because I don't actually need it.
I've really noticed that my body shape is changing. I feel like I'm toning up far easier. Because I'm eating the right things, I feel like my body is reacting when I do go to the gym in the right ways by toning up those areas. Whereas before I was doing the same stuff at the gym, but because I wasn't eating the right things, it wasn't having any effect.
I feel a bit like curvaceous. I've go in a bit more in the middle, which is good. And from the side, I think I look a bit slimmer, because every day I've got a full-length mirror and I literally check now every day, like as if I think I'm gonna be half the woman I was when I went to bed the night before.
Ready?
Yeah.
Do it.
The weigh-in is still to come, but remember, it's not just Faye and Laura's secret eating we've been spying on. With around 11 years of our lives spent away from the prying eyes of the family household, the workplace can become the perfect place for some sinful scoffing. So today we've placed two large cookie jars at this London firm, and our cameras are there to observe how they behave. One jar has been placed upstairs with the sales reps, whilst an identical snack trap has been placed downstairs in the workshop with our grease monkeys. Three different types of delicious bickies are on offer. On top are the modest rich tea. Underneath, it's the slightly more exciting custard cream, and at the bottom, the indulgent chocolate chip cookie. But how will they react, and who will make a break for the biscuits? Our sales reps are first to plunge their hands into the jar, but first impressions count with this lot, and no one is brave enough to delve further than our first layer. Not even this man in the nice blue tie. Downstairs, all eyes are under the bonnets, but fast forward to tea break time and our cookie jars in for a full service. But it looks like they've found a problem.
Why do they put the best ones at the bottom?
The question is, can they fix it? Yes, they can. Tuck in, fellas.
Hey, Sandy, do you want one of these biscuits for your diet?
With a chocolate chips.
I didn't know it was
these ones. I'll have one.
Yeah, one's not going to do too much harm.
Right, I need you.
But this guy's going for it. 4, 5, 6, 7 cookies. Careful, mate. You're in danger of overloading there. But what's this? Mr. Blue Tie has made a special trip down from sales, and while he's there, he might as well have another bicky. But he makes a discovery. Armed with news of what lies beneath, he heads straight back upstairs to incentivise his sales force to hit their targets. A whopping 74% of workers admit they scoff far more at work than they ever would at home. So if you do find yourself giving in to temptation like this lot, try not to get carried away. One biscuit on the lips could lead to a whole packet on your hips. Twelve weeks later, and back with Faye and Laura. They've been following a healthy eating plan set out by our dietitian Lynn after facing the reality of their secret eating.
In a month, that's the same number of calories as these 113 strawberry sundaes.
No!
If they've stuck to it, both should have lost weight. First to step on the scales is Laura, who 12 weeks ago weighed in at 15 stone 10.
Ready? Okay. Here we go. So that's 15 stone 2, so I've lost 8 pounds.
Oh, well done. That's really
I know, I'm pleased with that.
Will Faye be as successful? She started out at 19 stone.
Right, are you nervous?
Yeah.
Ready?
Yeah.
Do it. So that's 18 stone, 1 pound.
Oh, that's really good.
That's really good.
Faye's lost almost a stone in weight.
Well done, Faye.
Thanks.
Which means between them, they've shared an amazing 1.5 stone.
From out of nowhere, I've got like more willpower. I probably wouldn't have lasted this long if it was a diet, because with diets, you automatically think that you can't, I can't go out, I can't enjoy my life, or I can't, and then that's what makes you give up, whereas this, I've been making the right choices. I can still go out and enjoy my life, still go out for dinner with friends, same as anybody else can do, and lose weight at the same time.
I feel more confident in myself and how I look and what I can actually achieve. I'm so motivated and thrilled by what I've done so far. I just can't wait to just keep going and see where it takes me. I am no longer a secret eater.
Next time, we're helping to resolve the weight gain mystery of husband and wife Helena and Murray.
This is phenomenal.
Oh my God.
As our surveillance cameras reveal their secrets, are they willing to change the way they eat for good?
I've got to take you on the chin, haven't I?
Really? Which one now?
A workplace like no other. We're aboard the International Space Station with the people who make it their home. A major new season begins as Dermot O'Leary presents Astronauts Living in Space. Next.